From Agerpoint, I'm James Kotecki, and this is the Point Cloud on location at the AIM for Climate Summit in Washington, D.C. Joining me is the founder and CEO of Boomitra, Aadith Moorthy. Aadith, thank you so much for joining us today.
Thank you for having me.
And behind us are some escalators, so let's do the escalator pitch. What is Boomitra?
Boomitra works with farmers and ranchers around the world to help them increase soil carbon levels through improved agricultural practices. And then we measure that increase using satellites and AI to measure soil carbon levels, and then convert it into third-party certified internationally recognized carbon removal credits, which we then sell to corporations and governments around the world and return the majority of the value back to the farmers as an additional income for them.
So there's a farmer out there. Do the farmers actually actively seek you out because they're like, I got to get in the carbon credit game? Or are the farmers oftentimes not even aware that this kind of thing is possible?
Usually, in most parts of the world, the farmers might not necessarily be familiar. Mm-hmm. That's where we work with many partners on the ground, mm-hmm. from large agribusinesses to NGOs to more all around the world, and some governments and some intergovernmental organizations to enable farmers to really adopt the right things with the trusted folks on the ground.
Yeah.
Now, what I always tell folks is, it's not my job to parachute in from Silicon Valley into your small village and tell you what to do. Mm-hmm. Then you would have no reason to trust me. That's where our partners come in. They enable the farmers to adopt improved practices and enroll them for Boomitra's programs and enable them to benefit.
And so what kind of adoptive practices are we talking about? I assume growing more trees on the farm, agroforestry, is maybe one component of it.
That is one component that some people do, and it has many, many interesting benefits agroforestry has. But beyond that, there's also like the more conventional improved agriculture, regenerative agriculture practices like no-till, reduced-till, cover crops.
Yeah.
There's also grasslands. We also work in the grassland systems.
Yeah.
So in the grassland systems, you can do more of a rotational grazing, controlled grazing kinds of approaches, holistic management, holistic grazing kinds of approaches that enable you to sequester carbon even in grasslands through better management of the livestock that's on the grassland.
Interesting. So when and where those livestock are feeding can
actually
have a carbon impact.
Exactly, exactly. So we work with all sorts of practices all around the world. Really, at the end of the day, it boils down to what makes sense in that geographical region, in its social, economic, financial, and climatic conditions. What works in those conditions? We have to very carefully co-ideate that with people on the ground, with our partners on the ground, to choose the right ones.
And let's dive into the measurement aspect of this a bit more. You're talking about satellite measurements. Tell me a bit more about how that actually works in practice and how you validate that those measurements are correct.
Yeah, so we use over several dozen satellites and combine the data across those satellites in a data fusion. And then that goes through our AI system in order to produce absolute soil carbon levels. Now, how that AI system is built is by using large amounts of ground truth data. So we are very lucky through our partners and other relationships to have large amounts of ground truth data in many parts of the world, actual soil samples and soil tests done by as a large government soil survey or by large companies. Like, for example, like Yara, the crop nutrition fertilizer companies, invested in Boomitra, for example, like organizations like that, or it could be governments in some place of the world. So we have millions upon millions of soil sample and soil test data. That's basically a calibration set for us. And then we calibrate a separate system for each major part of the world.
Yeah.
And then we have an AI system where I can provide satellite data as an input and then get soil carbon numbers as an output. Because satellites, they only see the counts of photons of a particular wavelength from a particular location on the Earth. Then it's upon us using an AI system or otherwise to kind of derive some kind of useful insight. We tend to use an AI system that's calibrated with large amounts of ground truth data, and that enables us to translate those numbers of photons into actionable information.
And you're working around the world. Let's talk scope. Maybe just the ways that you might define the scope is in terms of number of people you're helping, carbon sequestered, how do you define it?
All of the above. We work today across like 5 million plus acres. There's like 150,000 plus farmers. We have a very inclusive view. We work with smallholder farmers with just an acre all the way to very large 100,000 plus acre ranches. We work across an entire spectrum from 1 acre to 100,000 acre. And in Asia and Africa, the farm sizes tend to be smaller. And there you have a lot of smallholder farmers that we work with. Just in India, for example, we work with 100,000 farmers just in India. But then you go to like Argentina, Mexico. These are, in some parts of these countries, there are huge land holdings across tens of thousands of acres, if not 100,000 acres. So we work across that entire spectrum. of different kinds of farms out there. Yeah, and in terms of acreage, 5 million plus acres, in terms of carbon sequestered so far, there's around like 10 million or so tons that are farms and ranches have collectively sequestered. That's just the tip of the iceberg, because at Boomitra, our goal is to reach gigaton scale and really move the needle on climate change by 2030. So we are gradually wrapping up to that. Currently, we are a mega scale company. We have to get it to a giga scale.
Well, tip of the iceberg is a metaphor that we all want to be able to continue to use, and we want our children to be able to understand what that metaphor means.
Exactly. So this is all a big exactly. part of that. Exactly.
What's your message to folks here at the Aim for Climate Summit in DC?
My message is, let's collaborate, let's work together, let's make it happen. Because agriculture is a very, very complicated subject that has many, many moving parts. There's the policies, there's the work by NGOs on the ground, there's work by the farmers, there's the corporates. The farming system itself has too many moving parts of how do you successfully make plants grow and produce the maximum amount of yield. There's so many moving parts. The only way for us to tackle this problem is to work together in the right ways, in the right possibilities. So at Boomitra, you know, one of our key things coming to Aim for Climate is to get more partners to extend this work around the world and let us together reach gigaton scale.
Are there certain kind of standards or policies that you want to see implemented either, you know, here nationally or worldwide that would help to make that possible?
Yes. So, of course, each country has its own set of policies, and there's nearly 200 countries in the world, and they all have slightly different policies. The important thing is for governments to properly promote the carbon markets and promote these kinds of good agriculture practice in the right way. The right way means allow the system's infrastructure to be there for a voluntary carbon market that can actually enable the farmers to earn for the carbon they are sequestering to properly exist, but put in the right guardrails. We can have some basic guardrails that a good percentage of the money has to go to the local communities or other kinds of things. Because in the past, in carbon markets, we've seen instances where farmers have received a very small portion of the total income that comes from the credits, or the local communities broadly, right? At Boomitra, we have a value that it must be majority going to the farmers and ranchers. There are certain guardrails that governments can put in, and overall, they can facilitate the development of the market. They should not restrict it too much to the point where people don't want to work in your country, but they should allow the system to work as well as possible to facilitate what can actually be done so that we can scale this up and reach every single farmer in many different countries. That's what needs to be done.
There's so much to do.
There's so much to do.
And as a final thought here at a conference and event that's really focused on innovation, is there a particular technology or breakthrough that you are looking forward to or hoping for that when you incorporate that into what you're doing will take you to the next level?
I would not necessarily say there's one technology or breakthrough, but there's probably a series of technology or breakthroughs around how can we help farmers to continually sequester more and more and more carbon? So carbon sequestration itself is not a step change process. It's not like I adopt one practice one day and that's it.
Right.
You have to sustain the carbon that's stored, then you also have to increase it over time. And in order to continue to increase it, we're going to probably require more and more innovation on the biologicals and soil amendments and all sorts of different sites in order to develop the products and technologies that can continue to increase carbon for decades to come. But I'm optimistic that we will be able to do that and put all of those pieces together with new innovations.
Well, thank you so much for sharing your optimism with us today, Aadith Moorthy, Boomitra. Thanks so much for joining us.
Thank you for having me. Thank you.
And thank you so much for watching. From AgerPoint, I'm James Kotecki at the Aim for Climate Summit in Washington, D.C., and this is The Point Cloud.